Hello, my name is Gabriel Fairman. I'm the founder and CEO of BureauWorks. And today I'll be talking about generative AI and the birth of a new translation paradigm. And before I get started, I want to talk about generative AI. A lot of people have different conceptions of what generative AI is and what it's not. A lot of it is based on prejudice, some of it is based on experience. But in our opinion, generative AI isn't something in and of itself. It is fundamentally what we make of it. We're not looking at generative AI as a replacement for machine translation. We're not looking at it as an enhancer of machine translation. We're looking at generative AI as a portal that changes fundamentally the way we as humans relate to machines. And I'll explain that throughout the presentation. I'm going to keep this light, I'm going to keep this exciting, and I'm going to keep translating this back to business goals and business purposes. First, a little bit about BWX, our tool. It's adopted and trusted by top global brands since 2005. Brands like Zendesk, brands like Uber, like Harley Davidson. We've been around the block for a while. Our technology is trusted, it's proven, very effective. And also, very interestingly, you'll notice when we get to pricing, it's very affordable too. And what has always moved us as a brand, as a company, is our drive to break paradigms and give birth to the new, whether it's organizational, technological, or even in terms of compensation. Now let's talk about organizational and how are we trying to be different about our approach, right? So what's the problem? We try to look at things from a very abstract perspective, right? The problem that we have as an industry, in my opinion at least, is how do you get the greatest amount of content translated in the shortest amount of time for the shortest cost possible with the highest quality possible. And obviously quality means different things for different people, but that's basically the problem that we're trying to solve. And towards solving this problem, we've developed an entire alphabet soup of LSPs and MLVs and SLVs and CAT tools and TMSs and QMSs and BMSs and all this stuff. And it gets complicated in our minds, but in the end, the problem is very simple, right? How do we make this become simple? And this paradigm that we've been working with, it's been going on forever. It's been for at least 40 years, right? We have the idea that we need a translation step, an editing step, a proofreading step. We need someone managing quality. We need someone adding terminology. We need this and that. And it's a very labor-intensive and it's a very cost-intensive process. And it's fundamentally incompatible with the age that we're moving towards, at least, again, my opinion. And generative AI really has opened the door for a completely new paradigm, a new way of thinking about knowledge, a new way of thinking about workflows, a new way of working about quality, costs, and again, fundamentally changing the way we operate with the translations as a human versus machine kind of idea. So this is BWX. This is our tool. It's our solution. It's SOC 2 Type 2. From a security perspective, it's built from the ground up with natural language processing and machine learning in mind. It's very powerful, very robust, and most importantly, it's integrated in a way with generative AI that's different than you probably have seen or imagined. So when we think about this old paradigm that I was discussing and the new paradigm, when, in my opinion at least, we're talking about a key differences, right? The old is focused on people driving processes. The new, in my opinion, is focused on data driving results. Manual, old, automated, new, line by line, old, concept by concept, new. Many workflow steps, single workflow steps with pulverized iterative learning. Monologic, old, like kind of like think radio, think TV. Dialogical, new, think social media, interaction, likes, comments, smart algorithms that know, can infer your behavior, your predicted behavior based on past behavior. Old, based on this more abstract idea of quality, and new, based on smart indicators and algorithms. Old, not thinking about AI, and new, leveraging the fullness of AI. So now let's talk about technologically how this ramifies through what we're doing, right? In this previous paradigm, and these numbers in this slide, they're more illustrative than anything else. The tech maybe took you 40% there. So just as an example, you know, you had translation memory leveraging, repetitions, fuzzies. Maybe it got rid of 40% of the work, or at least made the work 40% faster. Think it was definitely effective to some degree, but it was not fully effective, not nearly there. What we are seeing with our tech integrated with generative AI is we're seeing people get 90% there. So basically, yes, there's still fundamental, very important, relevant work to be done by translators, but the tech is taking us further and further down the road, which makes things a lot more exciting, a lot less expensive, a lot faster, a lot more productive. So when we think about it from a very contextual perspective in a translation editor, for instance, let's say you have a translation editor that is using some kind of machine translation, whether it's Microsoft, Depot, Google, AWS. Let's say you're using a glossary or many glossaries and a translation memory, many translation memories. What happens is the translator has to reconcile between all of these different things. So maybe it's an 83% match and they have to look at the differences between translation memory and the new segment that they're translating. Maybe they have to take a look at the discrepancies between the glossary and the translation memory. Maybe there's no match and they're working with a machine translation but have to apply the glossary to the machine translation or do some kind of concordance search in the TM to make sure that the machine translation is coinciding with the discourse that's being used, right? So there's a lot of manual textual reconciliation that takes a lot of time. And now what we're producing, what we're providing by our generative language engine that's powered by GPT 3.5 and 4 is this reconciliation is happening seamlessly as we translate this. And I'll show you as we move on through our demonstration. And what this does is all the lower level linguistic tasks like reconciling between glossary, like upgrading a fuzzy match to a match that's actually syntactically correct, like reconciling between machine translation and translation memory, that's done by the generative language engine. So the evolved paradigm really is about minimal editing with maximum impact, not because you're telling someone to do minimal editing, but because that's what it really takes. It's very fast. You can get everything done in a single workflow. Learning takes place dynamically, and instead of thinking words, think effort, right? That's the key thing about the new paradigm. So again, the previous paradigm, ineffective, costly, multiple rounds, and the key difference, learning takes place in a static, syntactical database. If you have a sentence, John went to the market, and another sentence that says John has gone to the store, semantically very similar, syntactically completely different. You can't leverage those sentences. In the new paradigm, we're adding layers to the translation experience, whether it's BWX Smells, that's a semantic runtime verifier, whether it's the critic that offers different alternatives for the same translation, whether it's the professor that's able to evaluate from a quality perspective the kinds of changes that's being done. As a translator, you're no longer translating on your own. You're being aided by all of these tools, by all of these enhancers that really augment the authorship experience. And that's where the generative language engine comes in. And from a cost perspective, this changes everything, right? Because again, what we're enabling you is to pay your supply chain, your vendors, people who are producing the work for you for the very last mile. Whether you're paying people per hour, whether you're paying people by edit distance, however the payment methodology that you choose to adopt, the technology, the fact that it brings you 90% there, that last 10% becomes a lot more cost effective to manage than the remaining 60% that you previously have. So we ran a study recently over 200,000 segments in the last month in 40 languages, and we're seeing 60% of the segments being confirmed with no changes at all using the generative language engine. And the thing of the generative language engine is that it gets better and better and better over time. So there's really not a need to keep making the same kinds of changes over and over again. So the translator, instead of having to, let's say, fight continuously an uphill battle in machine translation post-editing kind of scenario, they're becoming a language flow architect. So they're making changes that are being understood at a much more linguistic fundamental level than ever previously seen. So we are allowing you now to work effort-based, right? And there's an ethical philosophy behind this. And the idea is that, in our opinion, and again, this is just my opinion, we have to find a way where we can move forward, where we're at the same time becoming more competitive, more compatible with current market demands, and at the same time where we're really enhancing the human authorship experience. So that's what BWX is about, and hopefully you'll be able to make really good use of it. We really look forward to seeing you, and thank you.